Josephine.
See myself.
Just turn around. You can stay a little if you want to watch the video. Where's Sarah? You can come out and watch the video too. Come on out.
Bumpy Ryu. Okay.
Go up. Are you leaving or staying?
Lights. Camera.
I'm a bad guy. Fine. I'll be the bad guy. Josephine Lightmore.
Eliza to impart in her performance.
No, I never said, like, do this.
Okay.
But I was just saying, like, the way you just had to be me. Like, I think she just, we got close as friends.
Yeah.
And then she just kind of did me.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
She's like, you're being my friend. She's like, it's charity work. She's studying.
Eliza, how did you figure out her voice? Because you have a different, lighter lilt to your American accent when you played her. It's not necessarily Sarah's, but how did you decide on that voice?
I just wanted there to be a clear shift. And the most important thing to me was that you, when you were watching, you knew if it was Clark and you knew when it was Josephine. So I thought, you know, the most logical way to do that, since Clark spoke down here, was to kind of bring her up.
Yeah.
and that seemed to be effective.
It was, for sure. And you had the way you played Josephine was like almost an overconfidence, whereas Clark never came across that way.
Mm-hmm.
You just carried yourself like, yeah, I'm a badass bitch. Yeah. It was probably really fun for you.
So much fun, and like watching that just now made me go, oh, I need to rewatch this season. Because it was a blast.
So fun.
Yeah, it was a real reprieve too from just, not that I don't absolutely adore Clark, but like to not play that heaviness and to be light and kind of evil was awesome.
And also to wear dresses and nice things again.
Yeah.
And not be in the dirt.
Yeah. That was hard for me because because I'd been in the dirt for so long. I was like, what? I'm clean? Yeah, I didn't understand what was going on. It's just the dress. That was my favorite line. Yeah. I was staring at you. They're like, who is that? Yeah. Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Did you, like, when you're about to do one of these things, do you rewatch to kind of like,
or is, no?
No?
Not a
second. So you just, because your memory of everything is so impressive, I was just wondering.
That's because I wrote about the show, and I did a podcast about the show. That's the only reason I remember it. Although, right. To be fair, I only remember really 1 through 5.
Yeah.
Because then I counted.
Yeah.
What?
Excuse me?
It's pretty good.
It is good.
No, I enjoyed it, but no, I have not rewatched it. And to be honest, if I'm being completely honest, I have a little bit of fan trauma from post-Lexa, my experience with some people, and so it made me not enjoy it as much, so I have not ever rewatched it. That's just me.
I haven't done a rewatch either. Yeah. I would like to.
I think we're going to do a podcast.
Not a podcast.
Yes. Really,
yeah, rewatch podcast.
Yeah. It sounds like we're going to do a podcast before. What just happened?
We'll try and make it happen. Well, I don't. We don't have a lot of time, so if anyone wants to ask questions, we'll have you line up. You can ask Sarah and Eliza Josephine-ish related questions or whatever you want about their characters.
I'll be good. Hello?
There you go.
All right. I've been asking this. I know it's driving Joe crazy, and I apologize, but it's because I'm making something. So I'm working on making a tarot deck, but you can take a tarot deck and turn it also into playing cards. Okay? So I'm thinking about grabbing fan art from all the fans. I'm trying to get it to all of you guys. That's my idea. I know Ben, a person, I could make 1,000 of them, literally get them.
Wow.
So this is what I want to do. For you, my dear, I have picked out the Tower. I believe that is an excellent card for you.
Okay.
And for your little cohort who was just here a little bit ago, she was supposed to be the High Priestess because I had to put a scream out to her sealiness. And I really was sad I missed her, so I was trying to get a quick sign. And for you, my dear Sarah, I don't have any idea what to do with you just yet, and so I will figure it out soon enough. But I'm going to go real quick and shut the hell up here before Joe kills me. Because it's playing cards, what playing card would you like or that you think your character is? Does that make any sense?
Well, what game?
Just a regular deck of cards.
Oh!
Because that's what I'm using. I'm taking a deck of cards and you can do double duty with the cards. So I want to see if there, because I have other cards I have to play with. So what's like a card?
The Queen of Hearts?
I already got a Queen of Hearts. You missed that one, honey.
It's a Murray.
Just for you, kid.
Who's the king?
All right, so far I have Chelsea for the Queen of Hearts. I have Luce for Seven of Spades. Echo has taken the King of Spades, and you're available, and Allie over there has just taken the Ace of Spades.
Okay.
Pick a card.
The Ace of Hearts.
The Ace of Hearts? It's your time. Thank you.
Thank you!
I'm gonna now steal that card.
I forgot about you.
You
I'm
can't
so
steal
I wanna be the Death card.
I'm sorry, Octavia has it.
That's fair.
I'm very sorry. It was appropriate. Yes, it would be
seven
nice
of
for
seven
you.
Wands. I don't know.
Seven of Wands?
Yeah.
It's yours, kid.
Okay.
That would be a nice
but
one.
But only if it makes sense to you.
Oh, no.
And
I'll,
then, like,
I'll make you. I'll make you good. I promise.
And then you need to teach me how to do tarot.
I can do that.
Really?
Yeah.
I can
Day
do
night!
Day night!
Thank you.
Hi, how are you? My name is Sarah as well, so I have a question for Sarah. If Josephine had the chance to date Shade Hedda, would she?
Yes.
That is dark.
Yep.
By the way, I love that they made a drink called Joe Juice at the bar. Did you ever?
No, oh, that's right, they had Joe Juice. Yeah.
Jason told me it was a nod to me, and I'm like, thanks. It's Josephine, they shortened it to Joe.
It was a not too.
It was. He did say that. I think he was lying, but that's cute.
No, he put a lot of people little nods in there. So.
Well, I hope it was a bit of a nod to me, but I wasn't even supposed to be here. So.
No, not the bar here. The bar in Sancton.
On the set.
Oh,
in the show. They had a Josephine drink. They called it Joe Juice.
Yeah, Joe Juice.
Yeah.
Drink it all the time.
Which of Clark's memories do you think would entertain Josephine the most?
Say that again, sorry.
I'm sorry. Which of Clark's memories would you think entertained Josephine the most?
Which of Clark's memories entertained Josephine the most?
That's for you, right?
Well,
both of you. Well, we both played Joseph. Yeah, gotcha.
There's some real fun answers.
You want to answer the question?
No.
Yeah, I feel like you do.
Do you want to give us some options?
Yeah, because I can't, I don't know.
I mean, you saw all Clark with Lexa.
Yeah.
Sex.
But also Finn.
I was
going
to say it, but I wasn't
also
sure.
Finn.
Sex.
Yeah.
There you go. There's your answer.
It's a better answer than all the killing and murdering.
Yeah.
Yeah. Blowing up rounders.
Yeah.
It's too dark.
Yeah.
Josephine probably loved it.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Malika.
Hi.
So I have a question for Eliza. Do you actually believe that there are no good guys? Because you say that in the show.
I do say it in the show.
Do you really believe
it? I'm that annoying eternal optimist person who tries to see the good in everyone. So yeah, I think there are I think there are good guys. I do. But there are some bad guys too. Like, yeah. And there are good girls.
All girls are good.
Women. Yeah, no, I do. Oh, sorry, we're already on to the next question.
I was gonna wait.
My question was, obviously Clark plays a fairly, I would say, morally gray character, obviously. But how challenging and also fun was it to play just Josephine as like, for both of you, obviously, this like completely morally corrupt person?
So fun. So much fun.
It was the best.
Yeah.
Like, you just get to say the most bizarre things.
Yeah, like, she was fucked up.
And just, like, the way you look at people and, like, your reactions to things, I think, for both of us.
Yes.
Like, the way we would react, like, your scenes with Murphy as Josephine, I was jealous that I couldn't do it.
Yeah.
You know? Like, I'm like, I want that.
I know, it was so much fun. And, like, it's not, it's very rare that you get to share that character with another actor.
So
like,
weird.
That part was really cool. Like, we got to workshop and kind of be like, well, how are you doing this bit? How would you say this?
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
And, like, watch each other back.
Yes.
Like, we actually morphed more into each other as it went on, because you would watch my playback and I would watch how you were doing me, which made me more me, but more like you.
Yes. If you know what we mean.
Yeah, if you watch the show, you get it. It's all confusing.
Thank you.
I love your dress, by the way. Well, what did I walked into the room with all the memories on the wall and I was like, this is chaotic. What did I say? I'm like, haven't you ever heard of like organizational structure or something like that, right? So I think she was like, this bitch is a mess. But this is gonna be so fun, right? Because she's done so many terrible things, but she's also an amazing person. So it was, I think she was just like, oh yeah, this is gonna be a fun challenge.
Thank you.
And I have one for Sarah and one for Eliza. For Sarah, if there's any person Josephine could take over, who would it be, and could any of them make her slightly divorced? Like, it was in the parts.
So if Josephine took over someone else and it was like her choice,
or
would she? Probably Murphy, right? And could Murphy make Josephine remorseful?
No.
But I think that would be so fun.
And Eliza, I think a few days coming up, like the 10th anniversary of the Cruise premiere episode. So I guess, when was the first moment either acting in season one or watching it on TV and realize the show was becoming a good
It wasn't until, I don't know, like, it was a real, it crept up on us. And I mean, you were there for all of it.
Well, at the first Comic-Con in 2014, it was very well received. There was so much buzz about it.
It was well received. Like, that was shocking to me. I was like people, I didn't know if anyone would know who we were when we went to Comic-Con, and they did.
I watched the pilot live on TV, so I basically went to the show since.
Oh, wow.
OG, right?
You're an OG. That's awesome. Yeah. It's been a wild ride.
I'm going to pause for 1 second because Tara here can't walk, so I'm going to have her ask a question from her seat.
What would either of you think that Josephine would do if she could have got one head of power?
Oh, gosh. What a scary thought. What would she have done? I don't know. I mean, you wanted to, your whole thing was purifying the bloodline, right? Or something like that. Wasn't it?
I just wanted to like live forever.
You wanted to make everyone
be with Gabriel and like just live
forever. Oh, that's right, because you had a soft side too.
I loved myself.
You loved Gabriel.
I loved Gabriel.
Yeah.
And myself. And my dad.
And that's it.
That's it. I like my mom, but you know, my dad killed her, so.
Didn't you kill babies and stuff?
Listen, here's the thing about killing babies. It was never on the show, so there's no proof that I did that.
It was on the show.
Okay, yeah, no, it was. Oh my god. It was. I did. So sorry.
Wait, I've gotten off track. What would she do if she'd gotten one header's power or header up? Oh. What is one header's power?
Good question. Commander of Death.
Well, I know a title, but what really, what power did one header hold? She was kind of like a
myth.
Yeah, she was like this, yeah, lone.
She had a body count of about 800 by that point.
Believed in her, which made.
Right,
so
yes.
It was the kind of control of the people.
Yes, yes. Well, you would have either killed them all or.
I think I would have taken all of my loved ones, all of my chosen people, killed them, and made my people eternal in their bodies. Does that make sense?
But if they're dead, then they can't be.
No, but they die. Like, right?
They're not there anymore.
My people's brains would be in their bodies.
Right.
So you would just, yeah, you would do what you were doing.
I would keep doing what I was doing.
Yeah. Scary good answer.
Yes. Oh boy, I'm so sorry that I was like, what did I played one header. Like, what was her power? Anyway, it's been a long day.
Hi, I'm asking everyone a question for Sarah. If you could have played another character, as Sarah, who would you have wanted to play?
Murphy. It's my answer. It's always Murphy. One, because he's a great character. Also an asshole. With a heart. And two, because he's so cute.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
My name is Jane. I'm from Quebec City in Canada. And I have a question. I mean, you've been talking about books all day with Louisa's book club. And I wanted to know what your favorite books are and what you think Clark's and Josephine's favorite books would be.
Whoa. Whoa. Well, I only just recently started reading again. I haven't read in a very long time. I used to say my favorite book was The Alchemist.
I just reread that.
Did you? I haven't read it in years, so I don't know if it's my favorite still, because it's been a long time. But I'm nearly done with The Time Traveler's Wife, and it's a great book. It's really nice. It's my cup of tea. It might not be everybody's. I don't know enough books. This is like I said, I'm trying to get back into it. I don't know enough books to know what would be a good one for Clark. Have you thought about this? Do you have an idea?
No, I don't.
No, okay.
I mean,
one
of my favorite.
Let's workshop this.
Yeah,
I'm thinking about my dysfunctional family.
Yeah, something.
I think she needs a beach read. I think she needs something lighter. You know, maybe a rom-com.
Oh yeah, Teresa's a good person to ask about this.
Okay, what is the book?
It's called
Beach Read.
Yeah.
Yes.
Fluffy romance. You would need
Clark
that. Hard would need that. Yeah.
The one she was starring.
Yes.
The one that.
Oh yes.
Starring as Piper.
Yes.
But that book also has emotional depth and like deals with like processing family grief and like all of that.
Perfect.
Gotcha.
Clark needs to process family grief.
Oh, big time.
And a lot of therapy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. How about you?
Okay. One of my favorite books is Scar Tissue, Anthony Kiedis's biography.
It's amazing. I want to read it.
It's a fantastic
book. I'm obsessed, so that's probably my favorite book. Matthew Harris is also great. They're all great. But I don't know, Josephine's like probably the encyclopedia. Like, she's so smart. Like, she's like, words, yeah, let's learn them. Like, all of them.
Oh, yeah, she knew like eight languages.
She's the encyclopedia in every language.
Overachiever.
Thank you. That was a good question.
Head scratcher.
Hi, this is probably a deep cut, and feel free to come up with theories, or maybe this was going to be delved more into in the prequel series, but I always wondered what happened to the other Allegis mission ships, because Alpha was Sanctum, Beta crashed on Skyring, and then there's like Gamma, Delta, Epsilon.
And these are the ships, like the one that came down
to like the habitable planets, like around
Dio's ship. Yeah, that's what I thought. And what happened to
the other three ships? Cause like, and this is like
a deep dive.
So yeah, I don't know if either one of you guys have a thought.
I've never really had a theory on that, but I hear a spinoff.
All three ships were the base for the CW, which is no longer.
Yeah. I guess regardless, they transcended if they were there or not.
Yeah,
they're dead now.
I've watched that show. We'll write it together.
Yeah.
While we're doing the podcast. We're busy.
We're so busy.
Hi.
Hi. So first, just to shout out, both of you reacting in season 6 was just amazing. I told you this last night, Sarah, you're best villain ever.
Best.
So much fun to watch. Like, and
that's so sweet.
And I talked to you about this last night. It was just the kids in here. Mind fuck you had to go through. Like,
yeah.
All these different people, layers and layers and layers. But anyway, I just want to commend you on like the scene and never mind when you guys are like throwing Josephine's memories out the airlocks and stuff.
Oh, that was so much fun.
And it was
love that mind.
I really want to commend because there's really truly only one character I think the whole series that was just absolutely completely vile, and you actually were not. It was for Query. but that's because that was the one that was really neat to be able to see that make you feel for Josephine a little bit, like watching her memories and her being so sad. And then the one when she deleted one, you can see that she just got it, like she didn't know what she had lost. And it was, she did an amazing job
that.
Thank you. I remember
that scene
not knowing what to do
shocking.
With that, you know, because it was written, you know, she gets rid of this one and she doesn't want to get rid of it, and then she does, and then it was written that she's like empty. And like an emptiness in her eyes or something like that. And so that was, and I appreciate you saying that, because that was really hard to fill the emptiness and make sense of it. So
on a lighter note, my question is, because obviously you guys had a blast filming this season because of...
When is our show coming out?
Exactly, yes. But what was your favorite scene in season 6 that you filmed? Playing Josephine.
I mean, I had the most fun with all of that whole mind space sequence where we went through all the different, like, you know, you're just like poking around in my head and then I figure out how to get into yours and into your mind space.
Yeah.
They were called mind spaces, right?
Yeah, it was a mind space.
Yeah.
And it all kind of felt like one thing, because I guess it kind of was.
Yeah. It was cool.
Yeah, it was really fun. I can't like pinpoint a favorite moment, can you?
No. I just really, like, that whole thing, shooting all of that episode was super, like, it was just cool. I love all that sort of, like, you know, it almost seems like you're in a dream. It's like a lucid dream. I love that shit.
Yeah, we used the baby lens.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, I think what was actually really cool, and this is, like, not what was the most fun to work on, the whole thing was fun to work on. I can't even narrow it down, but it was really cool to see, because when I was working with Eliza, I was working with Clark. I was Josephine, so it was really fun to later watch her as Josephine and like be like,
Oh, she's making me look so good. Like, that was really cool.
One more comment, just really honestly, everybody in the room. How in the world did Welcome to Another Episode of No Good Choices, how did that not become like literally the tagline for the entire show?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's actually, yeah. You had some banger lines, like you really had some amazing one-liners that just like, singers.
Yes. Yes. All right, last two questions, then we gotta let these two go.
Okay.
Hi there, my name is Ron.
Hi.
I'd like to see most of my family on the tax today.
Oh, hello.
Wanted to ask, as Josephine, which of the previous series antagonists would you have wanted to collab with in one of your scenes?
As Josephine?
Yeah.
Who would I have loved to have?
Like, teamed up with.
Well, I mean, I loved the Murphy of it all, but that happened, so I can't answer with that. Josephine.
I agree. I think like the Murphy stuff.
It was so
together.
Yeah, it was really fun. That's all I can think of.
What do you think?
What do you think?
Honestly, I'm gonna be 100% truthful. I never got into.
The most iconic thing.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, that's so true. I see what you mean. Yeah. If Josephine had teamed up with one of those bad
Josephine versus Allie would have been really interesting.
Oh shit! Yeah. Yeah. Thank you for the question. It was a good one. I'm sorry I misinterpreted.
Excellent questions. We have to let them go, but let's thank these two for being here. Sarah and Eliza.
Have you all been sitting here for like 3 or 4 panels in a row?
Yep.
You guys are legends. Please hydrate, stretch.
Yeah, stretch
in the bathroom if you need to. Take your vitamins. Yeah. Okay. Thanks for being here, guys.